Hello and welcome to the e-learning platform of Galgutia's University. This is Suruchi Agarwal, Assistant Professor at Department of Mass Communication from Galgutia's University. And I am the course coordinator for the subject Basics of New Media. And today we will discuss about e-governance. So let's discuss about it. So what will be the learning objectives of this particular lecture? After completing this topic, student would be able to understand e-governance, reasons for opting e-governance, initiatives taken for e-governance in India, 9 pillars of Digital India, and issues related to e-governance. So what basically is e-governance? E-governance can be defined as the application of information and communication technology for providing government services, exchange of information, transactions, integration of previously existing services and information portals. The E in e-governance stand for electronic. The Council of Europe referred to e-governance as the use of electronic technologies in three areas of public action: relations between the public authorities and civil society, functioning of the public authorities at all stages of the democratic process, the provision of public services. So, reasons for opting e-governance. E-governance per se has become very complex. Increase in citizens' expectations from government. Different connotations of e-governance. So e-administration, the use of ICTs to modernize the state, the creation of data repositories for management information system, and computerization of records, land, health, etc. The e-services, the emphasis here is to bring the state closer to the citizens. For example, provision of online services, e-administration and e-services together constitute what is largely termed as e-government. So, e-governance is the use of IT to improve the ability of government to address the needs of society. It includes the publishing of policy and program related information to transact with citizens. It extends beyond provision of online services and covers the use of IT for strategic planning and reaching development goals of the government. E-democracy, the use of IT to facilitate the ability of all sections of society to participate in the governance of the state. Emphasis is on bringing transparency, accountability and participation of people. It includes online disclosures of policies, online grievance redressal, e-referendums, etc. So this is what is e-governance. The origin of e-governance. E-governance originated in India during the 1970s with the focus on in-house government applications in the areas of defense, economic, monitoring, planning and deployment of information and communication technology to manage data-intensive functions related to elections, census, tax administration, etc. Initial steps taken were establishment of Department of Electronics in 1970 was the first major steps towards e-governance in India, as it brought information and its communication to focus. National Informatics Center, established in 1977, launched the District Information System Program to computerize all district offices in the country. The main thrust for e-governance was provided by the launching of NICNET in 1987, the National Satellite Based Computer Network. After that, in the 1990s, the core ideas and techniques associated with putting governance online, President Bill Clinton's administration aimed to reinvent government. The United States and Britain, along with other countries, notably Canada and Australia, that led the way both in establishing a basic information form
of web presence, and in late 1990s, e-government became known and developed. So the what were the objectives behind it? Better services delivery to citizen, ushering in transparency and accountability, empowering people through information, also improving efficiency within government, that is between center state or interstates, improving interface with business and industry. The pillars of e-governance were people, process, technology and resources.
So what are the types of interaction in e-governance? Types of interaction, as the picture depicts, in e-governance, that is G2G, that is government to government, then that is G2G, that is government to government, then is G2B, that is government to business, G2C is government to citizen. So G2B is government to business, G2E is government to employees. So this is what is the interaction of government, or we can say types of interaction in e-governance. Initiatives taken for e-governance in India. So when we talk about what are the initiatives taken for e-governance in India, the first is the Bhumi project launched by Karnataka government, that is online delivery of land records. In this, Bhumi is a self-sustainable e-governance project for the computerized delivery of 20 million rural land records to 6.7 million farmers of Karnataka. Second program or initiative inside e-governance is Khajane, that is also launched by Karnataka government, that is end-to-end automation of government treasury system. In this, government-to-government e-governance initiative of the Karnataka state government, it has been implemented mainly to eliminate systematic deficiencies in the manual treasury system and for the efficient management of state finances. Third is third initiative, that is e-seva, launched by Andhra Pradesh government. Fourth is e-courts, that is launched by Department of Justice, Ministry of Law and Justice. And the Mission Mode project aims at utilizing technology for improved provisioning of judicial services to citizens. Third is e-district, launched by Department of Information and Technology. The MMP aims at delivering of high volume citizen-centric services at the district level, such as issue of birth, death certificate, income and caste certificates, old age and widow pension, etc. The sixth initiative is MCA 21. Another is e-office, launched by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances. This aims at significantly improving the operational efficiency of the government by transitioning to a less paper office. That is, paperless office means less utilization of environment or less misuse of environment. So, environment friendly office. Digital India initiative. In this, it is an umbrella program to prepare India for a knowledge-based information. It weaves together a large number of ideas and thoughts into a single comprehensive vision so that each of them is seen as part of a larger goal. So it has been launched by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, that is MeitY. And what are the vision areas? Vision areas is digital infrastructure as utility to every citizen, governance and services on demand, digital empowerment of citizens. So e-governance is getting momentum in India, but public awareness and digital divide are important issues to be addressed. The success of e-governance measures largely depending on the availability of high-speed internet, and the nationwide rollout of 5G technology in the near future will strengthen our resolve. So these are the few references from where you can gain in-depth knowledge about e-governance. So thank you very much for watching this lecture. Next time we will meet with some new and exciting topic. Thank you.